So friends, in our previous class, we already learned the meaning of commercial bank. Now it's time to learn about the functioning of commercial bank, because being at this age, you should be very clear about the banking, right? So how banking work, you should be aware, so that you can, as if now your teenage is going to be completed, right? So it's better for you to know about how banking work, how you can connect to the bank. Okay, so let's start with the functioning, taking a diagram. Suppose you are a public. Okay, it's obvious you are a public who is engaged in earning some income. Earning income, and that is why, as if you are earning, you are having excess income. Excess income means you are having extra income, that is that your consumption is less than your earnings. In that case, it means you are saving something. The earning of this public is basically divided into two parts. First, either he will gonna consume that consumption or saving, right? Now whatever he is saving, rather than keeping it in his locker at the house, it's better to save with the bank so that he can earn some interest, right? So he will go to the bank and submit the amount. You can say that here the first function that the bank perform is accepting deposits, right? Whatever the public have saved extra from the consumption, they can deposit that with the bank. So this is the first function of the bank. Secondly, as if now bank is having fund. Now what bank will do? As if bank is required to pay interest to public on its saving. So it's obvious bank should invest that, right? So bank will either invest the fund in some company, or what bank will do? Coming toward that public which is having shortage of fund, which means they require fund. So what they will do is they went to the bank and asked for the loan, permission for the loan. They request loan, okay? And what bank will do is either invest, or in case public is there, so bank will gonna lend the money to the public. So the next function of commercial bank is lending of funds as per the requirement of the public. Okay, this is all about the public which is having excess money, or the public which is having shortage of fund. Now coming toward the third type of public, which is the party, either for the first kind of public or for the second kind of public. Say they are this one, say Mr. X is here. Mr. X is here, this is Mr. Y, and this is Mr. Z. Mr. Z is here, okay? So now what this public is, this is say for Mr. X. Mr. X is supposed to make payment to Y, okay? As if Mr. X is the debtor for Mr. Y. Chances are there that Mr. X will provide check to Mr. Y, and Mr. Y will go to the bank and show that check and require, as if Mr. Y required fund, Mr. I will demand funds from the account of Mr. X, right? So the next facility provided by the bank is check facility. That is, it provides two kinds of check facility. First one is the bearer check, and second one is your cross check. Bearer check and cross check. Okay, what one mean by bearer check? First of all, by bearer check, one means the check which can be encashed immediately at bank counter. Okay, and by cross check one mean which are to be deposited only by or only in pay's account. That is, if Mr. X had paid to the Y by cross check, then the bank will not gonna make payment in cash, but bank will create an account at the name of Mr. Y, and now Mr. Y will become the member of the bank. Okay, now coming towards the fourth facility provided by the commercial bank. So if we will talk about Mr. X, Mr. Y and Mr. Z again, say Mr. X, who is having extra fund with the bank, right? So they are having children as well, children and or you can say parents as well, and the debtors are always there. So in case the Mr. X is having extra funds with the bank, Mr. X had deposited with the bank, what if Mr. X required to transfer the fund either at the name of the children or parent or at the name of the debtor? So what the next facility provided by bank is regarding remittance of fund, which means transfer of fund, remittance of fund. That means transfer of fund from one place to another, transfer of fund from one place to another, and basically the commercial bank performed this functioning due to interconnectivity of branches. Okay, now moving towards the next facility provided by the commercial bank is allied services. That means the other services, allied services, such as bill payment. We discussed if you have done your bills of exchange in your accountancy, bills payment, which means as well as you will gonna learn in the further classes as well. By bill payment means, say Mr. X is the debtor of Mr. Y. Mr. Y had drawn a bill at the name of Mr. X. Bill of exchange means after few months Mr. X will gonna make payment to Mr. Y, and today Mr. X is giving bills receivable to Mr. Y. Okay, this means that as if Mr. Y is now having bills receivable, it means they will gonna receive some amount. So in case Mr. Y in between that period require fund, it can directly go to the bank and discount the bill from the bank. Okay, other services such as your local facilities or your underwriting facilities means as if in case the company required fund, company required funds for that company, basically issue shares. And if the public is not interested in purchasing the shares, what the commercial bank do is commercial bank purchases the shares at the name of the underwriter and pay for those shares, and after that he can basically sell the share to the public whoever they want to. Okay, so the other service they perform is selling and buying of shares. Okay, so there are so many allied services as well that basically the commercial bank provide to their customer. Okay, so these are the functions that are performed by the commercial banks. Hope you got the concept of functioning of commercial bank. Hope you like the concept as well. Hope you now be easily able to connect yourself with the commercial banks. Okay, now as if you are able to know about the commercial bank, it will be easy for you to learn about the commercial bank, to become the member of the commercial bank. Okay, friends, if you like our classes, please download our app, Scholars Learning, for further classes. In case you have already downloaded our app, hope you guys are enjoying learning. Hope we are able to make your concepts clear and easy to learn. Thank you.